Abdominal wall defects occur very early in gestation.
The abdominal wall doesn't form exactly as it should. And as a result, abdominal contents can protrude out of the abdomen.
The two types of major abdominal wall defects that we deal with are generally grouped into omphaloceles or into gastroschisis.
The differences between a gastroschisis and an omphalocele, the major difference is that an omphalocele is usually midline, right in the middle. It's covered with a membrane, and it may or may not contain the liver.
If you can imagine a balloon full of abdominal organs on top of his stomach, born outside of the body, that's what he looked like when he was born.
Babies with omphaloceles fall into a wide spectrum.
And we can divide them up into small, which is bowel only, large, which is some liver, and giant, which is the majority of the liver. A gastroschisis is to the side of the umbilical cord, usually on the right side. There's no membrane, so the small and large intestine can protrude through this hole in the abdomen and go out into the amniotic fluid. The causes of these two major abdominal wall defects are unknown.
One thing that we know is that when very early in embryologic development, the bowel actually migrates out into the umbilical cord. And usually about 12 weeks or so, it's already migrating back into the abdomen where it kind of rotates and assumes its final position.
So we've all had an omphalocele at some point in time, but then the abdomen properly closed, whereas the way I explain it to parents is that with omphalocele, the abdominal wall defect forgot to close.
Abdominal wall defects are by themselves relatively rare problems in the newborn period.
We think for omphalocele it's probably one in every 4,000 to 7,000 births, which is just an estimate. For gastroschisis, about one in every 5,000 births, but it's interesting that gastroschisis worldwide is becoming more and more frequent.